My name is Rajkaran Mishra, and I am the sergeant at arms for today's meeting. On behalf of the EXCOM and the club, Bombay Toastmasters Club, I welcome all the fellow Toastmasters and guests to the meeting number 337. So before we proceed, there are a few guidelines that need to be followed in this online meeting. So I'll just read it out. So all Toastmasters are requested to rename themselves, prefixing with the Toastmaster, that is TM, and all the role players and the speakers are requested to rename themselves, prefixing with their role. All speakers are requested to do a quick audio and video check before they start their speech. And I would request you to not type in the chat box when the speaker is speaking, as it disturbs the speaker. You can use the private chat for providing the feedback to the speaker. You are all requested to keep your audio on mute in case you are not speaking. And finally, you should not click on the share screen unless your role requires you to do so. So with the rules on the ground, I would like to start the meeting with the Toastmasters Club mission. What we do, we provide positive and supportive learning environment in which members are empowered to develop communication and leadership skills, resulting in greater self-confidence and personal growth. With this, I would like to call upon someone who has just been participated in a singing event, the Toastmasters singing event. I have never known about that and just got to know about this. He's a passionate singer, a fan of Mohammed Rafi and Kishore Kumar. So put your hands together and let's hear from him what he's going to sing today for us. Please welcome our presiding officer and the president of Bombay Toastmasters Club, Mr. Toastmaster Babu Narayan. Over to you.
Thank you, Mr. Sergeant at Arms Rajkaran, for what I may call a sing-song introduction. I would be really glad and delighted to break out in some kind of a musical introduction. But I think first I may have to sit with the EXCOM and change some of the bylaws and of the club. If I have to do that, because I think for now we will have to stick to our protocol of speeches and introductions and addresses in our meeting. But surely, yes, I think if given an opportunity sometime, we will probably have that session as well. Thank you very much for that. And fellow Toastmasters and distinguished guests, good evening to yet another lovely session of Bombay Toastmasters. I was remembering the story about two friends who wanted to build a house. And one of them said, "You know what? I think I'll be happy building a house on the beach. I feel like being closer to the water." The other one was a bit wary of doing this. And he said, no, I think I'd rather go far away from the waters and build my house on a rock." Now, obviously, the difference between the two was one was a bit lazy and he felt that, I'd rather take the easy way out. And the other one was a hardworking, persevering type. And he decided that he'd rather not take the easy way out of doing things like his friend wanted to do. And it so happened that both of them went about their tasks, one building a house on the beach and finished it off very fast. And the other one took quite some time, drilling the rock and getting all the pillars up, and finally managed, yes, to complete the project. But this area was rather prone to storms and tsunamis. And it so happened that a few months down the line, a huge storm broke out in that area. And the storm hit the house that, whatever his name was, maybe the house that Jack built. And that house was blown away, was swept away in the waters. The point I'm making is that in life, we are often confronted by such typical situations of doing things which we tend to take a little easy. And there are situations where we'd rather go the hard way, knowing that perhaps that is more durable. It will withstand the rigors of our lives in the long run. I'm not going to pass a judgment on the best way, but I think we have often been confronted by choices of whether to make a beach house or whether to make a rock house in our lives, whether it's our own personal or professional lives. Now, which one do you prefer? Well, it depends on you. I leave that to ponder. So let us get on with our session today and see whether we have any new faces here. We have a couple of faces, not really new. We have had them at our session in the past. First up, I would like to invite one of our old Toastmasters, Mahesh Agarwal. Are you there, Mahesh?
Yeah, I'm there very much.
Let us hear your voice. So you can give a mini speech if you want to.
I'm not ready with any of the speech as of now, but good to see all the people back and excited to see the Toastmasters journey in a new format. When I was there, it was completely different at that time with online Zoom call. Yeah. And the way the SA has presented earlier, we used to meet in a meeting room where the dialogue was completely different. And now it's the changes has happened as the time passes by. So the revised approach, absolutely fine. And looking forward as well to joining once again in the Toastmasters. It has been a long time for me, but the office work has always kept me busy. So yeah. Now that's the reason I came here, to see what the new format and how things are. And accordingly, we'll take a call.
Nice to see that you haven't really lost your touch for speaking. Our doors, you know, are always welcome. So anytime, we'll be very happy to welcome you. Sure. On to our next, again, very familiar face at Bombay Toastmasters, but she's been in and out. Please put your hands together for Gayatri, and let's hear from her. Over to you, Gayatri.
Thank you so much, Babu. It is wonderful coming to Bombay Toastmasters. For past few weeks, I have been a little occupied on Saturdays and Sundays. But thanks to the lockdown in Maharashtra once again, yeah, I am available on Saturday evenings again. I'm looking for a complete power-packed session now.
Good. Nice to have you here. And we look forward to your participation as well, especially at the table topics. I've heard Gayatri at a few other club meetings, and I must say she really brings a lot of new ideas into the speaking, particularly at the table topics where I've heard her. So welcome once again. We also have speaker Rahul Jain. Of course, I'm sure he's a Toastmaster, but probably many of us do not really know him. So Rahul, would you like to say a few words?
Thank you, Toastmaster Babu. I'm from the Hyderabad Toastmasters Club, Division E2, Area E2, and District 98. We're looking forward, and thank you for this opportunity for having me as a speaker today.
Thank you for coming. It's our privilege, pleasure, and honor to have you here. And we have Grishma. Grishma?
Hello, sir.
Hello. Welcome. Can we hear from you? Grishma, are you there?
Can't hear you. Yes, sir.
I'm here. Cannot hear you. Let's hear from you.
Okay, so can you hear me?
Yeah.
So I am currently a third year student, and this is my first session in the Toastmasters, and I'm really excited to see how this goes.
Great. Thank you. Thank you very much. On to Lokesh. Lokesh Lee. Lokesh, are you there? Hello? Okay, I think lost connection. Great then. So nice to have all our guests in today. Welcome all of you once again. And in the light of the guests, I would also like to all of us to put our hands together for a few new members who have joined Bombay Toastmasters. So let us all put our hands together for Ashish, Sanchit, and Tina Arora. Welcome all of you to Bombay Toastmasters. Great. So now let us move on with our session today. And proceeding with the session, we have our Toastmaster for today. If you have seen the agenda, our Toastmaster of the day is a person who actually sent a message saying that she may not be able to join and take up the role. But I would say that it is really hats off to the endurance, to the commitment, and to the passion that a Toastmaster brings to this platform. In fact, Avantika has a personal, she had some personal problems at home, and she messaged me saying that she may not be able to make it. But it really is the courage and the dedication, I would say, of Toastmaster, who despite all her other issues, has decided that she would take up this role and be with us for at least a couple of hours this evening today. So please put your hands together and give a rousing round of applause to our Toastmaster of the day, Avantika Sood. Welcome, Avantika. Over to you.
Thank you so much, President Babu, for that wonderful introduction. I think the times are for now very difficult for all of us, but keeping our pace with the life is equally important. And so for me, today it works. Thanks once again, and good evening all my fellow Toastmasters and dear guests. Before I really begin, let me tell you all that we are going to be having a very exciting meeting today. And as we start, let me quickly explain you how today's program will work to again the audience. Toastmasters program consists of three major parts. During the first segment, we will hear speeches that have been prepared according to the objectives and guidelines mentioned in the Toastmasters pathway. Time frames for the speeches range from 5 to 7 minutes, or maybe it may go up to 10 minutes, depending on the speaker's objectives and project of the pathways being followed. The second segment of the program is called the table topic segment. It gives us all an opportunity to do some impromptu speaking. The table topics master will give us an interesting topic that we will talk about from 1 to 2 minutes. By the way, I encourage all of the present guests today in the meeting to be a participant in this segment. I'm sure you will have a great fun. In part three of the meeting, each prepared speaker will be evaluated by a fellow Toastmaster. The general evaluator for today's program will give you more information about this segment a little later. Also, during this portion, let me tell you that our grammarian will account for all the grammatical errors for us to prove upon. And the timer will let us know if the prepared speeches, the impromptu talks, and the evaluations are met in the required time frames. Do we have any questions from our guests? All right. My dear friends, wherever you are seated presently, take a minute to scan your surroundings. Are you familiar? Are you in a familiar place? Or is that you are at a place which is somewhere new to you? Stop thinking of all the other things and just look around you. To the right, to the left, at the back, and to the front. Pick out an object, maybe something that you hadn't noticed before, and focus your attention onto it. If you really focus, it will get brighter and more real. That is was when it was just an unnoticed piece on the background noise of your life. Now try to view your surroundings from the point of the object. Maybe some people can do this with no effort, and for others, it may take some concentration. Depending on how adept you are at focusing your concentration, you may notice a slight shift in your perception. A weird jump in reality, where you are suddenly viewing the world from a different perspective. Did it work for you? Whether, my friends, you noticed anything or not, your perception did change. Albeit for an instant, maybe. Be sure it's extremely important to be conscious of your perception. Because if you are not, someone else will create it for you. Things aren't always what they seem, right? Marketers and magicians rely on this fact to make you see things the way they want you to see them. Artists do that too. You may have seen Julian Beaver's amazing pavement drawings. He utilizes the trompe l'oeil technique, which means trick the eye. L'oeil in French stands for the word eyes. He uses his drawing stills to create a perception. Like an optical illusion, our mind attempts to fill in the details of something. It either thinks it already knows or doesn't quite understand. This works out fine when that's the intention. Momentarily, letting our world be shaped for fun. But wandering through life, letting others create your perceptions can make for a very unfulfilling life, my dear friends. And before I proceed further with our meeting today, let me now call upon our virtual podium the three most important pillars of every Toastmasters meeting. Inviting the first role player of the day who will help us monitor the language and grammar usage of every member participating in the meeting today. Let me call upon Toastmaster Vasudeva, the grammarian for the meeting. Over to you, Toastmaster Vasudeva.
Thank you, Madam Toastmaster of the day, Avantika. So good usage of language always helps in delivering the message very clearly and always helps on improving the quality of the speech. Hence, as the grammarian, my responsibility is to listen clearly to all the good usage of grammar, the good usage of language, proper usage of phrases, and at the same time, pay attention to all the incorrect usage of language as well, in order to help all the speakers improve their ability to deliver speeches. As grammarian, it is also my job to introduce the word of the day. The word of the day is comprehend. Comprehend means to have a complete understanding or knowing the meaning of something. I would urge all the speakers present today to please use the word of the day in their speech. And on that note, back to you, Toastmaster of the day, Avantika.
Thank you, Toastmaster Vasudeva, for all those details. The second role player of our meeting today is someone who will be helping us in recording the crutch words and sounds that we use during the session today. Calling upon the our counter of the day, Toastmaster Pratibha. Toastmaster Pratibha, over to you.
Thank you, Toastmaster of the day, Madam Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters and guests. The purpose of the our counter is to listen carefully to all speakers and note the number of below speaking errors for each participant. Words or sound used as crutch, such as ah, ooh, filler words like but, like, oh, okay, so, well, just, and filler phrases, you know, and so, I mean, any other fillers. I will be also noting down that few long pauses and short pauses, which are not part of the sentence structure. Over to you, Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you very much, Toastmaster Pratibha. Let me now introduce to you all the third role player of the meeting today, who will be helping us keep tab to our time spans of the evening, calling upon the timer of the day, Toastmaster Rajkaran. Toastmaster Rajkaran, over to you.
Thank you, Toastmaster of the day, Avantika. As a timer, my duty is to time the prepared speeches, table topics, and the evaluations. For the timing, I'll use the cards which will be displayed in my background. So when the speaker reaches the minimum time allotted, I'll display the green card. So I'll just change the background. When the speaker reaches the midpoint of the time allotted, I'll change it to yellow. And when the speaker reaches the maximum allotted time, I'll display the red card. I'll report the timings when called upon. Thank you, and over to you, Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you, Toastmaster Rajkaran. And thank you, team, for all those details. With this, let us now begin with our first segment of the meeting, the prepared speeches for the evening. But a minute, please. Before we step ahead with our first segment, let me take you through a short story, introducing you all to the part one of the complete three parts of this segment, this story segment. Washington, D.C. Metro Station, on a cold January morning, in 2007, the man with a violin played six bad pieces for about 45 minutes. During that time, approximately 2,000 people went through the station, most of them on their way to work. After 3 minutes, a middle-aged man noticed there was a musician playing. He slowed his pace and stopped for a few seconds, and then hurried to meet his schedule. 4 minutes later, the violinist received his first dollar. A woman threw the money in the hat and without stopping, continued to walk. At sixth minute, a young man leaned against the wall to listen to him, then looked at his watch and started to walk again. As we learn about the part 2 and 3 of the story, let me call upon the first evaluator of today's evening, Toastmaster Nivedita, to please present the speech objectives for the first speaker of the evening. Over to you, Toastmaster Nivedita.
Thank you, Madam Toastmaster. The objective of the first speech for today is to introduce himself and get comfortable with the public speech. Timer, please note the time is 4 to 6 minutes. Thank you, and over to you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Nivedita. May I now welcome Toastmaster Anurag, who is presenting his icebreaker speech today from the pathway Innovative Planning. Toastmaster Anurag, may you quickly do your audio and video check, please.
Hi, am I audible?
Yes, you are. Visible too? Thank you. Toastmaster Anurag, India Gate or Gateway of India, India Gate or Gateway of India, Toastmaster Anurag.
India Gate or Gateway of India. It's no brainer for me. I mean, if given a choice, I'll always pick Gateway in India Gate. Mumbai, the city of dreams, this is what everyone call it. But as I mentioned, I will always choose Delhi or India Gate. I never wanted to I never wanted to come to Mumbai at one point of time. But here I am, looking at the city with a different set of lenses. And yes, I have fallen in love with the city. Good evening, Toastmaster of the day, fellow Toastmaster and guest. I'm Anurag, born in Bihar, then moved to Assam, where my father was posted and serving in Indian Army. Then I moved to Delhi with my parents and sisters, two sisters. Delhi is the place where I grew up and spent the golden days of my life. I did my schooling, bachelor in computers and masters in cyber law and network security. My mother was a teacher, so you can well imagine the culture at home. You know, father was an army officer and mother was a teacher. So you can imagine the culture at home. So as I mentioned, Delhi was the place where I spent the golden days of my life. And after completing my studies, I realized that my golden days are over and I have to worry about everything, including expenses. And my first brush with Mumbai was just after my college, where I first came to Mumbai with the dream in my eyes about the city, the lifestyle, the Bollywood and late nights parties and whatnot. But how stupid I was. When I came here, I could not find anything of that sort. And I just saw the narrow roads, the crowded city and the traffic galore. Then at that point, I decided I will never come to Mumbai. But as we all know, we are aware, man proposes, God disposes. When I joined the company in Delhi, my company expected me to join the office in Mumbai. So I had to come back to Mumbai again, which I never wanted in my life. That is the time where struggle started in my life, with less of salary, no place to stay, and worse, I didn't know anyone in this big city. I literally survived on the vada pav and puri bhaji for 2 years. But God Almighty had different plans for me. I got promoted in my company with increment in salary, which helped me to move to YMCA Bombay Central. And thank God, the food was much better at that place. when at one point of time I realized that I'm kind of settled in my life, I tried running back to, or you know, moving back to Delhi, which was the like the city which I always loved. So I did this movement from Mumbai to Delhi thrice in my life, but every time, because of some or the other reason, I had to come back to Mumbai. So that point of time, I realized that this is the karam bhumi or the workplace for me, and it is futile running back and forth. And I acknowledge it and accepted that this is the place where I have to be here. And this city has given me what I always wished for. And yes, this is the place where a dreams come true. Professionally, I am a certified security professional, which requires the job, which requires meeting the top management in an organization, as we make them loosen the purse strings. I still distinctly remember the evening when my boss called me and asked me to present a new product launch of our company to our partners, business partner in Kolkata. I remember that evening I could not sleep. Entire night I spent on internet, browsing multiple websites and YouTubes to learn how to deliver a good speech in front of an audience, big audience. But all in vain. It was like I realized at the end of the day, I realized that it is learning and flying an aircraft, gathering the knowledge from YouTube. So it was like I couldn't do anything. And when I went in that room, conference room, I still remember I could not speak. My throat ran dry. I couldn't utter a word, and just I was flipping these slides aimlessly and still don't remember a single word what I spoke in front of the audience. And I, like as I mentioned, my throat ran dry and I did not have the water, excess of water bottle, at least to drink. That brought, and this kind of incident, multiple incident has happened with me in different events or conferences, as it requires, I mean, my role requires this kind of presentation to be given in the large audience. So that brought me to the Toastmaster, and I hope that I could improvise on my skill, which is where I'm lacking, and to be a good speaker and deliver a convincing speech to my partners and customers. And before I close my speech, I would say, trust yourself, have patience, and keep working the way, you know, keep working in a harder manner. Thank you, and over to you, Toastmaster of the Day.
Toastmaster Anurag, for sharing your journey from India Gate to the Gateway of India. Giving you all 30 seconds to provide your feedback to Toastmaster Anurag in the private chat box.
Requesting Madam Toastmaster so that we can stand and giving us a standing.
Thank you.
Congratulations, Anurag, on completing your first milestones.
Thank you so much.
Thirty seconds for everyone to please share your feedback to Toastmaster Anurag in the private chat box. All right. minutes had passed, a 3-year-old boy stopped, but his mother tugged him along hurriedly. The kid stopped to look at the violinist again, but the mother pushed hard and the child continued to walk, turning his head all the time. This action was repeated by several other children. Every parent, without exception, forced their child to move on quickly. 30 minutes had crossed. The musician played continuously. Only 6 people stopped and listened for a short while. About 20 gave money but continued to walk at their normal pace. The man had collected a total of $32 by now. 45 minutes had passed. He had finished playing and silence took over. No one noticed. No one applauded, nor was there any recognition. Before I unfold what happened next, it's time for me to call upon Toastmaster Manan, the evaluator of our second speaker, to present the speech objectives of our speaker piece. Over to you, Toastmaster Manan.
Thank you, Toastmaster Avantika. Our next speaker, Toastmaster Rahul, is going to deliver a speech from Pathways Effective Coaching. His speech level is L1-P2, and the objectives of the speeches of the speech are: the purpose for this project is for the member to present the speech on any topic, receive feedback, and apply that feedback to a second speech. The purpose of this speech is for the member to present the speech and receive feedback and apply it to his next speech. Timer, please note that timing limits are 5 to 7 minutes. Over to you, Toastmaster Avantika.
Thank you, Toastmaster Manan. Our next speaker is an entrepreneur by profession and a motivational speaker by passion. He started his Toastmaster journey as a speech crafter in the year 2019 and joined Hyderabad Toastmaster in August 2019. Join me in welcoming Toastmaster Rahul, who is presenting his Level 1 Project 2 from Pathway Effective Coaching. Toastmaster Rahul, may you quickly do your audio and video check, please.
Thank you, Toastmaster Timothy Avantika. Am I audible and visible?
Yes, you are. Thank you so much. Toastmaster Rahul, special Toastmaster Rahul.
What if I tell you today is Mother's Day? Would you act or feel any different? I wouldn't, and let me explain you why. Good evening, Toastmasters, guests present over here. 12th of May 2018, a special day in my life, Mother's Day. I woke up to a bright sunny morning, went on to make a special cup of masala chai for my mom, woke her up, presented her a gift, took her out for shopping, went for a dinner date, and finally, at the end of the day, lying on her lap, I said, "I love you, mom." And then went on to ask, "Did you feel special today? Or how did you feel today?" She responded, "I felt loved." And that made me beam with gratitude for making my mother feeling special on a special day. But just then she added, "If only I could feel even a little of this feeling for the rest of the year." And she went on to the room. Sitting there, trying to comprehend what just happened, I started to reflect on the other days of the year. It made me feel that while
I had grand celebrations on the special day. My expression of love for my mother was completely absent on the other days. The things which we do, I love you, or different ways of expressing that, were missing. I had become a man of only occasions. While I did have the gratitude that she is my mother and she's special to me, what was oblivious of the situation was my expression of that spirit. Have you been where I was? Or are you still? Whether it's Mother's Day, Valentine's Day, Father's Day, Diwali, Eid, Christmas, New Year, whatever be it, why do we have so much of grand celebrations on a specific day and find it hard to express that feeling which we have on the rest of the days? Isn't your friend a month before Friendship Day? Need not be true for the Valentine's though. But what's changing on the 1st of January that wasn't on, say, 10th of April, that you're making resolutions, you're thinking of making new beginnings? Isn't it just that the day has been imprinted in our minds as special and we act in a way because it is special? When I observe the details, when I look deeper into our expression of whatever spirit that you're talking of, the spirit is rather simple. While we try to make the grandeur of it on the special days, but the spirit of it is simple. So I decided to bristle the expression of whatever I felt through the year. I said more often, I love you to my mom. I took her on a long ride, surprised her with dinner dates. With my wife, I didn't say I love you often, but I made that bed tea for her. I felt and expressed what I felt at that point in time in the moment. And I didn't wait for special days for that moment. But do you know what really cemented this idea deep within me? It was death, or rather, a near experience of death. I've always had a very formal relationship with my dad, talking to him mostly about the transactional nature of how are you, or how's the business, or whatever you're doing. Up until 28th of June, 2020, when my dad was infected with COVID and he was in the ICU. At the 2:30, I got a call from the ICU asking me, can you give a consent for incubation to put your dad on ventilator if need be? I was dumbstruck. The entire life and the entire world that I had was running in my mind. All those things which I wanted to always say to my dad rushed in my mind. They rushed in my mind, and that's where I realized we all wait and lead our entire lives with an elusive hope that tomorrow I'll do it. Tomorrow will be a day when I'll be being something, doing something, experiencing something. But tomorrow, my father luckily survived. A few days later, I hugged him. I broke the ice of what I was experiencing. I started to call him more often, have deeper conversations with him, and build the bond with him over these last 9 months that we are right now into. But I was lucky that he survived. The beauty of life is that we all know when we are born, but are you sure you know someone's death date? The bonds improved. There was joy in my life, experiencing of calmness and peace that I live in this moment and do not hold back whatever I want to express or experience to some other day. There are times when my dad candidly says, I'm not sure what's changed, but be sure, I'm not going to sign any papers right away. And that's what changed. Let me ask you all today, as we close, as we come to an end of what I'm sharing, ask yourself of the three things or three special occasions, relationships, whatever you celebrate in grandeur, ask yourself, what are you waiting for? Today is special. Now is special. Make your life special. Over to you, Timon.
Thank you, Toastmaster Rahul. Giving you all 30 seconds to provide your feedback to Toastmaster Rahul in the private chat box. No one really comprehended, but the violinist was Joshua Bell, one of the greatest musicians in the world. He played one of the most intricate pieces ever written with a violin worth $3.5 million. 2 days before, Joshua Bell sold out a theater in Boston where the seats averaged $100. This is a true story. Joshua Bell playing incognito in the metro station was organized by the Washington Post as part of their social experiment about perception, taste, and people's priorities. The questions raised in a commonplace environment and an inappropriate time, how do we perceive beauty? Do we stop to appreciate it? Do we recognize talent in an unexpected context? One possible conclusion reached from this experiment could be, if we do not have a moment to stop and listen to the one of the best musicians in the world playing some of the finest music ever written with one of the most beautiful instrument ever made, how many other things are we missing? I had told you, you remember, to look around you, to see what you are really missing, to view it from a different perception, take it from a different thought, the world will be different for you. As I complete reading out the last page of this story on perception, I would like to invite the evaluator of our third speaker of the evening, Toastmaster Dinesh, to read out the objectives of our next speaker. Toastmaster Dinesh, over to you.
Thank you, Avantika. Today's speaker, TM Dilip, under pathway Dynamic Leadership. He is presenting his speech incorporating the recommendations given to him in his previous speech titled 21 minute only. All the best, TM Dilip. Over to you, TM Odi.
Thank you, Toastmaster Dinesh. May I now welcome Toastmaster Dilip, who is going to present his level 1 project 3 from the pathway Dynamic Leadership. Toastmaster Dilip, may you quickly do your audio and video check, please.
Hello, am I audible?
Yes. Would it be possible to be a little louder?
Okay. In every day, there are 1,440.
I'm sorry. Okay. Toastmaster Dilip, 21 minutes only. 21 minutes only, Toastmaster Dilip.
In every day, there are 1,440 minutes. That means we have daily 1,440 opportunities to make positive impacts. The quote is from Les Brown. 21 minutes of exercise a day could boost lifespan by more than 3 years. Toastmaster of the Day, fellow Toastmasters, and my dear guests. I would like to take this opportunity to tell you a story of a corporate guy by the name Mr. Rahul. Currently, he is battling his life in ICU. His family members, wife, son, and daughter are all sitting outside. He had a heart attack, and his family members feel that they are responsible for his health. While at ICU bed, Mr. Rahul feels that had he listened to his doctor 20 years ago of doing daily exercise, this current situation could have been avoided. His realization that it was his mistake which made his family members suffer or cry currently was very late. Please don't neglect your health and be conscious of daily physical activity, as many fail to comprehend the fitness of being fit. Research has proven just how much increasing your activity levels can improve your lifespan. Just like to narrate a study of 6,600 people over 12 months, which was carried out by Vitality Health. People who increase their activity levels to 150 minutes a week, that is about 20 minutes only a day, so their life expectancy increased by more than 3 years. That's the current UK national guidelines amount of exercise needed for adults. But if that seems unachievable, the researchers found that moving for just 90 or 60 minutes a week increased lifespans by 2.7 years and 2.4 years respectively. The researchers calculated their findings by analyzing each participant's vitality age. Let us understand how this is calculated. This is an aggregate measure of wellness that evaluates the gap between physical body age and actual age. By surveying the participants before and after they made changes to their everyday behavior, the researchers were able to assess the impact of behavior on life expectancy. Now, one way in which experts are doing this by showing the public how we can be everyday athletes. For example, one hour of gardening, walking upstairs at work daily, getting off the bus stop early, and walking 1 hour of housework like sweeping, mopping, that will also add up. The idea is just to make a small change, such as taking the stairs or standing for an hour. Or you can factor exercise into your daily routine without trying. And all these calories you can burn really add up. Now, we all know that there are lots of options for doing physical activity. You have option of going for gym, yoga, swimming, jogging. Most of the options are available at your place. But people get confused, like, which to choose. Now, today I will give you an example how I choose between yoga and gymming. In fact, for me, both are very good and I adopted both of them in my daily life. But still, I will give you a little understanding the differentiation between going to a gym or doing yoga. Yoga, as you know, once learned, can be performed at home without any equipment and does not require any investment, whereas for gymming, one has to shell out your annual fees or monthly fees along with the protein supplements. The benefits with doing yoga is that, as we all know, that yoga is the union of mind, body, and soul. It cleanses the internal organs and responsible for smooth functioning of vital organs of the body. It is like similar like how you clean your drainage. It is similarly, your veins are cleaned, blood vessels are cleaned in similar fashions. Whereas when you go to gym, you have an aesthetic body. It's good to look from the outside, but there is nothing much happened from the inside. Let me show you more much benefits of doing physical activity. Like, it can feel you happier. It can help with weight loss. It is good for muscles and bones. It increases your energy levels. It reduces your risk for chronic disease. It helps your skin health. It helps your brain health and memory. Also help with relaxation and sleep quality. It reduces pain. The best part that it very good family life at home also. I wanted to imbibe this, I wanted to have these benefits. I wanted to incorporate this in my daily life. What I did, I enrolled myself in gym. I took a membership, whole year membership, and then appointed a personal trainer also. And I booked a morning batch of 6:30. And I daily wake up at 5:30 so that I can call right now myself at 5:30 a.m. because I don't want to be land up as what Mr. Rahul had to go. I do get a chance of doing yoga asanas if my gym is closed. Like today, I did yoga asanas to compensate my gym going. Take it very seriously. Your health is at your hands. Over to you, Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you very much, Toastmaster Dilip. Allowing everyone a 30 seconds time to post the feedback on the private chat to Toastmaster Dilip. We all get caught up in our own stories. Most of us think we are our stories. It's when those stories take on a life of their own and that life isn't the way we want. The things we say are starting to shed. Think about the story you are living right now. Who wrote it? Did you consciously decide the reality you are living now? Or was it mainly shaped by anybody known to you? Maybe your parents, friends, spouse, school, or the media. While I leave you all with this question, I am now moving ahead to onto the next segment. But before that, let me please call upon the timer to present the timing report of our prepared speeches. Toastmaster Raj Karan.
Thank you, Toastmaster of the Day, Avantika. The timing reports for the prepared speech. Toastmaster Anurag took 7 minutes and 5 seconds. Toastmaster Rahul took 7 minutes and 20 seconds. Toastmaster Dilip took 6 minutes and 6 seconds. So for Anurag, he has taken 35 seconds more, so he'll not be qualified for the vote. And as there are only 2 speakers qualified for the vote, there will not be any voting for the best prepared speech. Thank you, and over to you, TMOD Avantika.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Raj Karan. As I said, it's now time for us to move on to the next segment of the meeting today. Please join me in welcoming Toastmaster Vikram, who is going to be the table topic master for us all during this meeting. Toastmaster Vikram, over to you.
Thank you, Toastmaster of the day. Am I audible?
Yes, you are.
Toastmaster of the day, fellow Toastmasters and guests. One of the most exciting portions of the Toastmasters meeting is the table topic session. The main objective is to challenge members to develop their impromptu communication skills to effectively think on their feet by answering unrehearsed questions. We use table topics to give every member and our guests the opportunity to participate in each meeting. One of the great benefits of table topics is that you learn to think on your feet. This is a great skill to have in situations where you are unexpectedly called to speak about something that you have not prepared for. Dad, you should grow through life, not go through life. This is what my son told me this morning, a paraphrase that I use often for him. He was aghast and he could not comprehend that I am writing chits for my table topic session in this age of technology revolution. So he quickly got into action and he created a technology platform for me, which I could use to conduct the session. So we'll be using a two-step approach. I'll just share my screen. So we have a spinning wheel with names of all the participants written on the spinning wheel. This includes both Toastmasters as well as guests. And I'll be spinning the wheel one by one. And then whoever is the lucky one will get to choose a topic. So I'm sharing another screen where we have the topics behind these blue boxes. And once I click these boxes, there'll be a topic that will be displayed. Once a topic is spoken about, it will turn red. So the next speaker will have the choice to select from the remaining topics. This is how we'll conduct the table topic session for today. So I'll start, I'll invite the timer to give the timing instructions for this session.
Thank you, Table Topic Master Vikram, for inviting me. So as a timer, my duty is for the table topics is to time the table topics speeches. So the minimum time allotted is 1 minute and the maximum time allotted is 2 minutes. The speaker is required to speak for at least 1 minute. There is no grace period before the minimum allotted time. However, there is 30 seconds grace period after the maximum time allotted, which is 2 minutes. So when the speaker reaches the minimum time allotted, I'll display the green card in my background. And when he or she reaches the 1 minute and 30 seconds, that is the mid range, I'll display the yellow card. And when he or she reaches the maximum time allotted, I'll display the red card. When I called upon, I'll present my report. And over to you, Table Topic Master Vikram.
Thank you, Toastmaster Rajkaran. We'll start with the first topic for today. So I'll spin the wheel. Okay, we have Toastmaster Tina. So Toastmaster Tina, could you please unmute yourself? We'll move on to the other platform. Which number would you like to select?
3.
Okay. Toastmaster Tina, healing through a hobby. Healing through a hobby, Toastmaster Tina, over to you.
Okay. Healing through a hobby. And while everyone talks about yoga, mindfulness, I believe one hobby that all of us must instill is called stillfulness. Stillfulness basically means that you're in a state where you just sit still, do nothing, stare at something meaninglessly, scribble on a piece of paper, just breathe normal. Yoga teaches you a lot of breathing activities. So does mindfulness, staying focused on something. But I think what's lacking in our lives right now is being still. Sanskrit comes up with 3 words called the sattva, the rajas, and the tamas. Sattva basically means the balance that comes through stillfulness. Rajas basically means the focus, and tamas means chaos. Our lives are a lot more of rajas and tamas, which is chaos and action. I think what we need to instill is sattva, and that's how we can heal through developing this hobby of stillfulness.
Thank you, Toastmaster Tina. That was really insightful. We'll now move on to the next class. We'll just move on to the next one. Again, I'll spin the wheel. Okay, so it's Toastmaster Babu. So Toastmaster Babu, I'll share my screen. I hope you can see the numbers here. Which number would you like to select?
7.
Toastmaster Babu, we have to design a successful life. We have to design a successful life, Toastmaster Babu. Over to you.
Table topics master, fellow Toastmasters and distinguished guests. I go back to the story which I started out with in my address of the two friends who thought that both of them were doing two great things to probably design a very successful life. And this is where perception became a very important and defining factor. Behind every successful man, I won't say really there is a successful woman. I would say there are successful ideas, vision, and goals which he sets for himself. So I think when you are pursuing successful pursuits in life, we need to have a head firmly on our shoulders. And this is not something which comes out of a magic formula or a mantra. I think this is going to be based on the kind of hard work, persistence, perseverance that we are willing to do in all walks of life. Like I said, sometimes we tend to take the easy way out, the short route to success. But this success is very illusionary and doesn't stay for a long time. So we need to really put the hard yards into our lives if we are really going to achieve something which is called a very lasting and a successful life. And I would say for this, each one of us is in a good position to design our lives. And when I say design, it means all about planning, execution, and achieving those goals. So surely, much like you have a design in any other field of activity, I'm sure it is also possible to design a very successful life if you are ambitious and you are willing to really put the hard yards. Over to you, Table Topics Master.
Thank you, Toastmaster Babu. That was a very good perspective. We'll move on to the next table topic. I'm spinning the wheel again. Okay, Toastmaster Dilip. So Toastmaster Dilip, I'll go to the list of, I'll go to the numbers. Which one would you want to choose?
Sorry, Table Topic Master.
Sorry, which? Toastmaster Dilip?
Number 5.
Okay. Toastmaster Dilip, opportunities don't happen, you create them. Opportunities don't happen, you create them. Toastmaster Dilip, over to you.
Yes, saying opportunities do not happen, you create it. There was a time when I was struggling for a job post my college education, but I could notice that in my area, lot of unfit people were there. Mostly I could see even ladies were unhealthy. Even as they are mostly in their household works, but they do not get time to be fit. They're after the children, after taking care of the husbands and all. But giving time to the fitness was not there. And that time I had a degree of as a yoga instructor. So I utilized that opportunity to build a regular monthly income. I took 5 ladies at a time and started teaching them. And the best part that from 5 ladies, it became to 15. And for 6 months, I continuously taught them the asanas, only the basic asanas. And I found that, you know, initially I was looking for a job here and there. But since it was in my only society, the job was there. So I created that job for myself, and pocket money was very much available at that time due to that opportunity created by me only. Over to you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Dilip. We'll move on to the next table topic. So the next lucky winner is Toastmaster Manish. So Toastmaster Manish.
Yes, I'm here.
So what is your choice of the number?
Topic one.
Toastmaster Manish, the effects of happiness on potential. The effects of happiness on potential, Toastmaster Manish. Over to you.
Happiness indeed is important in life. If you are happy, you tend to do well in other spheres of life as well. So being happy is of paramount importance, and it ultimately leads you to what you want to achieve, to your desires. For me, being happy is being with my daughter. That very feeling of coming home to her means a lot to me. And you want to finish off work early just so that you can get home on time and be with her. So that leads to a lot of different things. Teaching her teaches me a lot of things. Helping her with her studies also helps me with a lot of things. So in a way, being happy, being with her makes me happy, and being happy makes me more productive, makes me achieve more. So yes, being happy improves your potential to achieve more. I am a follower of getting things done method, the GTD method. And as a part of that, I note down my to-dos and plan them for the week also. So, you know, thanks to that, I always keep in mind that, you know, what is it that I will have to finish off today just so that I can get home early and be with her. That, in a way, leads me to be more productive and achieve more. Over to you, Table Topics Master.
Thank you, Toastmaster Manish. In fact, I learned a new acronym, GTD. So I think this is something that we should all imbibe in our lives. So I'll move on to the next table topic. So we have time, I think, only for a couple of more topics. Anybody, I don't think we'll be able to, anybody who wants to volunteer, or otherwise I'll go with the spinning wheel. If anybody wants to volunteer, most welcome.
Vikram, I have a suggestion. Why don't you call our guests who have not spoken?
Yes, exactly. Sure. A guest, one of the guests can be called.
Sure, definitely. So again, I would request any of the guests to come forward and choose a topic. Anybody from guests?
Gayatri, you want to try? Who's there?
That Grishma was there, na?
Grishma is there. Lokesh.
Yes, sir. Can I try?
Sure. Is it Grishma?
Yes.
Okay. So you can choose any topic from the ones in blue.
Grishma, if possible, please unmute your video so that we can see you. Thanks.
Just a second. Is my video visible?
Yes, yes. So, can you choose a number from the blue boxes?
Topic number 8.
Okay. So, guest Grishma, it's good to make mistakes. It's good to make mistakes, guest Grishma. Over to you.
Hello, Table Topics Master, fellow Toastmasters and guests. I'm Grishma, and today I'm going to speak about it's good to make mistakes. So first I would start, like, I have, as a student, I have made many mistakes, which I think need to be improved, and I'm working on that. But the thing that I have learned is making mistakes opens new doors for us. It also helps us narrow down our way to what we must not choose or what we do not want to do in our life. So coming around, I can say that making mistakes is really good. But on the other hand, if we do make mistakes, we should learn to improve them and work on them and learn from them. A little example I would like to give is we hear as students, many elders say, do not do this or that, because these are the mistakes we have already made. And you should not repeat them, but learn from them. Differ here is a mistake someone else makes and a mistake you make. Both have different consequences. So to actually know the consequences and learn from them, I think it is important to make the mistake, but also keep in mind the advice the elders give and sort our mistakes and make it. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Grishma. That was a very good effort. I think we are just on time for the session. So we'll have to conclude it here. Before we conclude, may I request the timer to present his report?
Thank you, Table Topic Master Vikram. So congratulations to all the table topic speakers, because there has been no disqualifications and everyone will be eligible for the vote for the best table topic speech. And over to you, Table Topic Master Vikram.
Thank you, Toastmaster Rajkaran. I'll now conclude this session with a quote on perception, which is the topic of the day. It is said that there are things which are known and there are things that are unknown, and in between are the doors of perception. So life depends on how we take things and not how they are. Over to you, Toastmaster of the day. Thank you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Vikram, for that wonderful session. I'm sure that all of our participants really did enjoy the topics today. Remember the question I left you all with? Think about the story you are living right now. Who wrote it? Did you consciously decide to create the reality you are living now? Or was it mainly shaped by someone known to you? Maybe your parents, friends, spouse, school, or the media? Let me tell you, my dear friends, if you don't like the story you are living, then you need to probably change the perception. Envision how you would write the next chapter of your story. Better yet, actually sit down and write it. And all this can be done as you focus your perception on creating a new reality, pushing back all the thoughts, all the doubts that you hold. One, well, you are the in charge of your own story. Take back the job as a script writer and a director, and stop being an actor. In life, everything begins with a decision. Decide now to be in charge of your own perception of reality. Because if you don't do it now, there are plenty of folks around whose sole purpose in life is to craft that perception for you. Do you really trust them to have your best interest in mind? To take us to the last part of the session today, may I now invite Toastmaster Chetan, the general evaluator of our today's meeting, to take us ahead with the third part of the Toastmasters meeting. Over to you, Toastmaster Chetan.
Thank you, TMOD. I think a huge round of applause for the TMOD. I think coming on the meeting with whatever personal issues that she had and doing it so well, I think just explaining all the three concepts. Thank you, TMOD Avantika. Now, they say, and no matter how good you dress yourself, I think you need a mirror to tell you how good you are looking. So now, no matter how good you do the Toastmaster meeting, you need evaluation to tell you how good you have done. So I'll be evaluating. So we have the entire evaluation section is divided into three parts. One is the first, we have the speech evaluators. Then we have the tag team, which will give the report. And then I'll give my take on the entire meeting. And in Toastmasters, as you know, everything is time bound. So let me first call upon the timer to give the guidelines for the evaluators. What you timer, Rajkiran?
Thank you, General Evaluator Chetan, for inviting me. So for the evaluations, the timing, the time allotted is 2 to 3 minutes. There is 30 seconds grace period before 2 minutes and 30 seconds after the maximum time allotted, that is 3 minutes. So when the speaker reaches the minimum time allotted, I'll display the green card. When the speaker reaches the midpoint, I'll display the yellow card. And when the speaker reaches the maximum allotted time, which is 3 minutes, I'll display the red card. And I'll share my report when called upon. Thank you, and over to you, General Evaluator Chetan.
Thank you, Timer Toastmaster Rajkiran. So to quickly start, may I call upon the first evaluator, Toastmaster Nivedita, to give the evaluation of the icebreaker speech by Toastmaster Anurag. Nivedita, over to you.
Thank you. Thank you, General Evaluator. Once again, very good evening to all, and Speaker Anurag in particular. Smile is always a good introduction. That's what today's Speaker Anurag has done and made his first appearance special. Second best part is the title and the start, India Gate or Gateway of India, which is different yet intriguing. I got some clue, like IPL started yesterday, something Mumbai and Delhi match will happen here as well. And the good part here is Mumbai scored higher than Delhi by a Delhi eye. That's the best part. Anurag, you have given good information about your family, your college, your education, your career, and more important, your journey from Bihar to Mumbai via Delhi with multiple round trips between Delhi and Mumbai. The vivid description about Mumbai is apt, with traffic, narrow roads, and most important, food that help us to comprehend Anurag as a person. And last part, which I appreciate, is the smooth transition you made from your office work to join at PTM. So while all this good, something you can add which will help you to make your speech much better is to have a good clarity in your speech. You may add some vocal variety, because when you are like some happy moments, when you got a good food in while you were in Mumbai Central, or you have some anxiety, feeling of anxiety, fear when you heard your boss, when you asked to do a presentation by your boss. So that will help us to hook to your or connect or engage to your speech better. You were confident in your speech, but taking off attention away from the camera may perceive you as a less confident. So suggesting you to make a conscious effort to look at the camera and talk to us. All in all, the last point is, make 3 to 4 main points and add 2 to 3 sub points for each main point, so that you will complete your speech well on time and you will not exceed the time. Okay. All in all, I enjoyed your India Gate to Gateway of India journey. And let me tell you, you have started your Toastmaster journey by achieving the objective of your first speech. And I'm sure you will excel in your every speech with these suggestions. All the best for your Toastmaster journey. Thank you, and over to you, General Evaluator.
Thank you, Toastmaster Nivedita. May I call upon the evaluator Manan, second evaluator, to evaluate the speech of Toastmaster Rahul. Over to you, Manan.
Thank you, Toastmaster Chetan. Special. That was not only the title of your speech, but also the message which was wrapped in that speech. Toastmaster Rahul, congratulations for that wonderful, emotional and inspiring speech. Well, for a moment, the title of the famous Bollywood movie came into my mind, Kal Ho Na Ho. That means today is the day we need to express to our near and dear ones. And what best time than right now when we are with them. So why wait for tomorrow? Toastmaster Rahul, there were many strong points in your speech. And one was definitely your pleasing personality. You chose to stand up for giving your speech. And there was this constant movement when you came close to the laptop to emphasize at certain moments of your speech that really helped audience to connect to your speech. Another important point was the fact that your speech was in a storytelling mode. And it seemed that you were conversing with your audience, with giving them the exact dates, like the 20th June 2020 or the 18th May 2018. That brought more authenticity to already your real life incidents. Even more, the fact that you used humor when you said that your father even doubted that he would not write your will, that brought the humor part into your speech. So that was also good. But most important fact was the underlying message that the act of showing your love or your gratitude should not be limited to a specific day. It is independent of the occasion because every day is special in its own sense. So congratulations, Toastmaster Rahul, for sharing us with that idea. Having said so, although your speech was near to perfect, but still, I believe there are certain points you could have done to enhance the effect of it. For example, at the moment when you said that what really brought about this change in your attitude, you narrated your incident of 20th June 2020. But at that moment, it was a perfect moment. You could have taken a halt or a pause. But my attitude changed on 20th June 2020. A sudden change in your facial expression and a pause could have engrossed the audience to wait what was coming, and then you could have continued that it was the COVID and how your father was going to get into the ventilator mode. So that could have enhanced the speech. But overall, with a powerful message, a strong communication mode, even in this online platform, and a very pleasing personality, I hope you continue to deliver such inspiring speech. Over to you, Toastmaster Avantika.
Thanks. Thank you, Toastmaster Manan. It's over to General Evaluator. Yeah. Hello. Yeah. May I call upon now Toastmaster Dinesh to give evaluation for the speech of Toastmaster Dilip?
Yes.
Dinesh,
thank you. Thank you, General Evaluator Chetan. Toastmaster Dilip, your speech was very, very inspiring. I think all of us sitting here were inspired to incorporate exercises in their daily routine from today onwards. Your opening was good. You said 1441 opportunities in 1441 minutes. In your previous speech, the recommendations which were given by the previous evaluator were number one, to give the benefits which daily exercise gives to the person. And number two was, how did you go about imbibing this 20 minute exercise routine in your daily life? You beautifully incorporated both the recommendations. You gave approximately 10 recommendations, 10 benefits, which the exercise, daily exercise gives you, which includes high energy level, good mental state, and so on and so forth. For the second recommendation, how did you imbibe? You said your first commitment, you firstly committed yourself to number two, I would like to say that a little bit of voice modulation could have made your speech more effective. All in all, your speech was very inspiring. Your opening was good. You incorporated all the recommendations given by your previous evaluator, and you could make your speech better by adding emotions and voice variety in your speech. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Toastmaster Dinesh, for that evaluation. Can we have the timer, Rajkaran, to give the timing taken by all the evaluators? Do we have Rajkaran?
Thank you, General Evaluator. Actually, for the last speech, I had lost my internet connection. So I was not able to show the timing cards properly. But when I joined, it was 4 minutes and 15 seconds. So I directly shown the red card. So speech evaluator Nivedita took 3 minutes and 13 seconds. Manan took 3 minutes and 30 seconds. And Dinesh was not able to qualify because he exceeded the time limit. That is 4 minutes and 15 seconds. So as there are only 2 speakers qualified for the vote, there will not be any voting for the best evaluator. Thank you, and over to you.
All right. Thank you. Thank you, timer Toastmaster Rajkaran. Now the second important team, if I can borrow a word from the TMOD, the pillars of the meeting, the tag team, the timer, our counter, and the Gamerian. So to start with the timer report we just had, now can we have the our counter, Toastmaster Pratibha, to give a report?
Thank you, General Evaluator. The our counter for today's meeting is like this. Toastmaster Anurag, 1 R, but 2, so 1, repeats 1, and 4. And I, 3 times, and short pauses, 4. Toastmaster Rahul, but 3, repeats 2. Dilip, R, 4 times, and repeats 3 times, also 3 times. Tina, 6 R. Vikram, 2.
A, and Grishma, I think, and three times. Chetan, I think, two times. Repetitions, three times. And so, two times. A, three times. Rajkaran, so, three times. The, one time. And A, three times. Nivedita, repetition, three times. And three times. Dinesh, A, four times. And two times. And short pauses, three. Repetitions, two times. Over to you, general evaluator.
Thank you, our counter, Toastmaster Pratibha. Can we have the grammarian for the day, Toastmaster Vasudeva, here to give us the report?
Thank you, general evaluator Chetan. So the grammarian report, I must say, is very pleasing today. We have both positives and some places of improvements in equal measure. So I would start the grammarian report with the usage of the word of the day, and there have been some speakers who did use it. These are the Toastmaster of the day, Avantika, speaker Rahul Jain, the table topics master Vikram, and Toastmaster Nivedita. Moving on from the usage of the word of the day, the good use of grammar. So we had some really lovely phrases, which are as follows. First brush with Mumbai, and silence took over. Stories take a life of their own. Take back the job of director and scriptwriter and stop being the actor. Man proposes, God disposes. Loosen the purse strings. Throat ran dry. Man of only occasion. Drizzle the spirit of occasion. Union of mind, body and soul. Wanted to imbibe, head firmly on our shoulders. This success is very illusionary. Do well in other spheres of life. And finally, moving on to some improper use of grammar. So the word albeit was pronounced as all bite. So the correct pronunciation is albeit. Referred to by people is the correct way of saying, instead of people called it. Galore of traffic is the correct way of saying, instead of traffic galore. I couldn't get the incorrect pronunciation, but the right way of saying this phrase is, I am somewhat settled. Browsing YouTube videos is correct instead of browsing YouTubes. I hope to improve my speaking skill is another proper usage of grammar. Near-death experience is the correct way because it's a shorter phrase, and it gives the same message instead of saying an experience that was close to death, where, you know, probably you're using more words. Person from corporate world is slightly better usage instead of corporate guy, which can be perceived as unprofessional. Made his family cry is again correct instead of suffer a cry. Spending 1 hour doing work such as walking from the bus stand, sweeping. So this is again a proper usage of grammar. And lastly, choose between yoga and gym exercise is the correct way instead of saying choose between yoga and gymming. And on that note, I hand it back to you, General Evaluator Chetan.
Thank you, Toastmaster. Thank you, Grammarian Toastmaster Vasudevaya, for your report. Okay, now it's my take on the entire meeting that we have had so far. We started on time as usual, so thanks to Rajkaran for that. Now, as we started, we greeted the old members. I think we hope to see them more often in our meetings in time to come. Toastmaster Mahesh and others that have joined today. Great start by the TMOD. I think first, before that, great start by the presiding officer. I think the way he's been addressing the meeting over the last many, many times, I think that's itself adding to the spice of the overall meeting, and it makes it more interesting. I think we are only waiting to see what TMOD have to say, but now he himself has created a kind of niche for himself, the presiding officer, by coming up with very interesting story every time. So thanks for that. And thanks to TMOD again, once again, for attending out of all the difficulties that she's been going through today. So thank you once again for that. That shows how committed you are with your kind of the assignment that you have taken up. I think it would have been difficult for anyone else. Tag team, indeed, they are the pillars. I think thanks for using that. And I'm going to use it every time I'm going to be the TMOD or the G or anything in the meeting. The word of the day was used by many people comprehend. I think the grammarian chose the right word for the meeting per se. Speaker one, I think we all survive on Vada Pav, have survived on Vada Pav, Toastmasters, Anurag. It's not just you who have come from Delhi and survived. I think people living in Mumbai also have survived on Vada Pav and sandwiches many times during their lifetime so far. Speaker two, we had a speaker from Hyderabad. I think it's always good to have, at once in a while, not always, but once in a while, have a speaker from other Toastmasters to have different perspective, different way of presenting and different bringing a new flavor to what to a particular topic. So I think it was good to have Toastmaster Rahul for our meeting. Hope to see you attending our meetings in the future as guest as well in time to come. So that's it. Speaker three, I think Toastmaster Anura Dilip. I think you were to share a screen, I guess. I think, let me show you something. I think you could have, if I heard you correctly, there was some screen sharing option over there. If not, then you should have showed some screen. I think a presentation for a topic like that you had chosen, I think it could have made things far more interesting than what it is. And this is just my observation to all, I think to all the speakers and to all those who are listening. It would be better if you give the speech standing rather than sitting on a chair or a sofa or something like that, because that gives you some kind of a comfort while you giving the speech. I think what we missed from the physical meeting to the online meeting is giving the speech while standing. I think while giving a speaker at PTV also, we all used to stand and give the speech. So try and see if you can do that. I think giving the speech on standing, that will be make a little more some kind of an environment the way if you give the speech in a physical meeting. So let's, like all the Toastmasters, like they when they give the speech at the contest, they stand and give. So I think let's follow the same practice while you are at the club as well. So give your speech while you are standing. So that would be a good practice to start with. I should specifically mention the table topic master. I think we all had a table topics master earlier spinning the numbers. I think for the first time we had the spinning the names. I think that is something very innovative to say it. I think it was something that I'm going to use the technology from you. I think all the Toastmaster table topic master in the future should use this technology, and the spinning the names. I think seeing your names, I think that adds a spice. I think you always set new standards to table topic master, no matter which role you take up in the meeting. My only thing is, I think it was later on pointed out by the senior Toastmaster Manish and Babu to call up the other Toastmasters and guests for the meeting. So whenever any table topic master in the future, whenever we are doing anything as spinning the wheel per se, just list down all the other Toastmasters who are attending the meeting and the guests, and try and call the first 5-7 numbers from them, and then take up all the, because as per the norm at BTM and others as well, the speakers and the role players are given the chance. The speaker are not given the chance to speak at the table topic because they already have had the chance as a speaker. All the evaluators and other role players are given chance at the end if you don't have anybody else as a speaker. So do that next time around. And overall, I would say, I think everybody were to the point and they spoke as per the requirement. I think it was a good meeting overall. I think we stick to the time. It's still 7:11. And if I go by the time that we have, I think we are just on time to complete my evaluation section. So on that note, let me hand over the floor to the TMOD of the day, Toastmaster Avantika. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you very much, Toastmaster Chetan. I am now taking this opportunity to thank all the Toastmasters and guests for being present in our meeting today. Without your presence, interest, and support, the successful meeting would not have been possible. Saying this, I would now like to hand over the meeting control back to our presiding officer, Toastmaster Babu. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Madam Toastmaster of the day, for that comprehensive, I would say, insight into the theme, pushing past perceptions. Wonderfully done. And under the circumstances, it sounded even sweeter, I would say. The General Evaluator has presented a comprehensive report and thanked all the role players. But I think it is my duty, and there is no harm in perhaps repeating our ovation and applause for all the role players who have performed so very well today. In particular, all the TAG team and all those who don't really get noticed very often. So let's all put our hands together for all the speakers, evaluators, the table topics master, the toast master, everyone, the Zoom master, everyone. Wonderfully done. Talking about the work behind the scenes, if our sessions go on like clockwork every week, we have the role players in place, we have the dropouts getting filled up, and the sessions going on seamlessly, there is at least one person whom we should not necessarily thank, but definitely recognize the efforts. And I would say that is our VP Education, Nivedita, who really burns the midnight oil and to make sure that, you know, all the roles are in place. Even today, I think there was a slight hiccup, but she managed it. So Nivedita, very well done. Brilliant.
I think, thank you. Thanks.
And in particular, also, I would like to applaud one particular role player. In fact, today I was at an area contest and there was a technical glitch and the Zoom master disappeared. In fact, he couldn't come back online. And not the Zoom master, sorry, I think it was a contest chair. Yes, the contest chair of the Table Topics contest suddenly dropped off. And the area director, who didn't have any script or he was not ready for it, had to step in. And that is when I realized how important a role the Zoom master plays in any meeting. And today we have had Rajkaran not just play the Zoom master's role, he's done a 3-in-1 today. He's been the sergeant at arms, he's been the timer, and he's been the Zoom master and providing all the links. I think this really calls for a very special applause for Rajkaran.
Thank you so much.
But having said all of this, I must say that there is a tinge of sadness which is also associated today. And perhaps many of you may not be aware that Toastmaster Rajkaran recently lost his beloved younger brother. So I think Amar from Bombay Toastmasters, we all express our heartfelt condolences and pray for the soul to rest in peace. And I would suggest that we just observe a minute of silence in the memory of the departed soul. Thank you, everyone. Our thoughts are with you and your family, Rajkaran, and we do hope that you have the necessary courage to go through these difficult times. Moving ahead, I must also appreciate and recognize the valiant effort, the grit, and the determination of two of our Toastmasters who have also been out of action for quite some time, and of whom one of them has come back for the meeting. Let us all applaud the efforts of and the grit of Chaitya and Yashokrita, who had been hospitalized recently, and they have both come back. One of them, of course, Chaitya, is here, and I hope Yashokrita will be back very soon at our meetings. A few other announcements. Of course, I will give the privilege to Nivedita, but before that, just to remind all of you that tomorrow morning we have our two contests, our the B1 contest, of which we are BTM is a club member, and we have our own Ankit and Sudha, who will be part of that. And then the B2 contest, which is my area as an area director. So the B2 is in the morning, 9:30 to 11:30, and the BTM participation will be from 11:30 to 1:30. So once again, sincere request to all of you to kindly register today in advance and try and be present at least to cheer up our own participants at tomorrow's contest. I also would like to commend two of our members who will be taking up the roles of contest chair. I just happened to see a poster. I think it was Manish and Vasudev who have taken up roles, or have you completed it? Is the contest over?
Yeah, the contest is over. It's over. Oh, okay, great. Ended this afternoon.
Oh, fantastic. That's nice. So I think we should also give them a huge round of applause, because as Toastmasters, it is also our duty to offer our services or assistance or whatever you call it to other clubs, as much as we also have them coming over. And in this context, I must congratulate Toastmaster Rahul for making this special effort to come today and deliver a wonderful speech. So we should give him also a huge, huge round of applause.
He left, but we can applaud.
Yeah, we can convey it to him. Yeah. A couple of other things which I thought I would mention is that we should all pat ourselves on the back for the fact that as a club, we have been able to achieve the DCP points, the DCP goals, 10 out of 10. So I think a huge round of applause to the XCOM as well as the members for having contributed to the achievement in great measure to all the completion of the speeches in the various levels, which has contributed to 6 of the points, and the others relating to the membership and the administrative goals. In fact, in these difficult times where membership is a struggle for many clubs, I think we are doing reasonably well. If I'm not mistaken, the last count was 33 members, which is a decent number, I would say, but definitely we should not rest on these numbers. And let's hope that all those who have not renewed will do so in times to come. Before I go to the awards, let me call on a couple of guests who have perhaps not spoken or who have and who would like to come over again. Grishma, you are there, right? Would you like to say a few words about the meeting? How did you feel, and what do you want to, what are your observations?
Hello, sir. The meeting was good, and I did learn many points which I can inculcate in my speech. without even giving the speech, I learned them just by observing. So overall, it was a very good experience.
Great. You are based here in Mumbai or outside?
I'm based in Mumbai.
Mumbai, okay. Fine. So do come over for our future sessions. I'm sure you'll enjoy them. Okay. I don't think we have any more of our guests today. So let us now move on to the awards. Okay. I think we have... what about the prepared speeches?
So there was one time. Did not qualify that for the time, so we don't have
time. Okay, okay.
It will be only the best speaker
and
best of big three.
Yeah, one is for the table topics and one is the best of big three. So the table topics award goes to, I can't recognize the name of this person. It's written as B-A-B-U. I think it's myself. So
let's put Apani Anna pilot ka.
I think then the policeman will get an award for catching me.
Babu, it was a really good acting.
Yeah, I think Nivedita was wondering who is this.
No, I am not wondering.
I hope there's no rigging, Babu.
And the best of big three goes to the Toastmaster of the day, Avantika. I think Avantika has to leave, so
she's not. Yeah.
No problem at all. Yeah. So good. So before we conclude, I would like to hand over the reins to Nivedita, if she has got anything to say for the next session or anything else.
Okay, so I just want to reiterate what Presiding Officer Babu has said. We will all be present for our area contest tomorrow morning at 11:30 a.m. We will share the invite once again so that it will be handy for all. Similar to that, we will have a division contest on Saturday 17th and 18th. So we request your presence for that and for so. And with that, we don't have a meeting on 17th and 18th. So we will have a meeting, on 17th. And so we will have a meeting directly on 24th. So role players are invited as usual. But I see this after this. What you can say, renewal, there is a renewed enthusiasm amongst all the members. So to start your speeches, to take up the role, especially new members, as well as the existing members, to come forward and take your roles, complete your speeches, complete your pathways as early as possible, and leverage the Toastmaster as maximum as possible. That's it from my side. Over to you, Babu.
Thank you, Madam Toastmaster Nivedita, for those announcements. In fact, yes, I forgot to mention about the division. And since you mentioned about the division, may I also go further and say that we are going to have the district as well in May. I think it would be around May 21st, 22nd. So you can block your dates, and that is going to be hopefully an online extravaganza. So let us all try and attend. We're going to have some speakers, wonderful speakers, I believe. I don't know whether anyone here is part of the eloquence team. Chetan, are you part?
Not yet.
Okay. But yeah, it promises to be an extravaganza. So let us block our dates for that and be present. Chaitya, are you there?
Yes.
Okay. Chaitya, Rahul, our guest speaker, before leaving, he posted a link wherein I think you can bunch all these different social media, links together. And perhaps you can also send it around to all the members, maybe as a small mail, because in the chat box, it just disappears. And after that, we'll forget it. So if you can do that,
yes.
And then I would request all of you to go and and see those links. We have LinkedIn, we have Instagram, Facebook. So I'm sure there are a lot of interesting things there, including our own posts. I think with that, we've almost come to the end of the meeting today. All those guests or even the new members, Tina, Grishma, anyone else who would like to stay back for 5-10 minutes in case you have anything to ask, you're welcome. Otherwise, officially, I declare this meeting closed. Have a good evening and a good weekend.
Thank you. Good evening.
Bye. Good weekend. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Good evening.
Grishma, you have anything to ask?
By the way, Tina is a returning member.
Yeah,
but I believe she was here only for 2 months. So to me, that's hardly a... I mean, it's okay. It's nice to have her back.
Yeah, but she was there during the CCCL regime. This is now Pathways regime. So things have moved on.
Because I asked her which year and when and all that. So she said, I think